Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the structural formula, the bond line formula and IUPAC name of the isomer of a molecular formula, that is C5H10. So let us talk about that, how different kind of isomers that we could draw about the molecular formula that has been provided, that is C5H10. So let us talk about that. So now we are going to draw the structural formula, bond line formula, and we are going to give the IUPAC nomenclature for the isomers of the C5H10. So now we are going to draw the different possibilities of the isomers of the molecular formula C5H10. So let us start with the first one. So talking about the first one, having the molecular formula C5H10, we could consider the straight chain without any branching. So even that could be represented in this manner. I'm talking about the first one, where it consists of basically 5 carbon atoms, that is in a straight chain, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon atoms that are being present in a straight chain. But since the name, the molecular formula is C5H10, that means it clearly indicates that it is an alkene and it consists of only one double bond. And that one double bond can be on this carbon also. So let us name it first by numbering it. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the first isomer that we have drawn about C5H10, and here it is what we will fulfill the hydrogen atoms. So this is H2 over here, even H2 over here, here it will be H and here will be CH2. So in this case, if we count whether we are drawn the alkene or not, or whether we have drawn or satisfied the C5H10, that molecular formula or not, so let's check it once. So this is one carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms are been already, so therefore we are talking about C5. Talking about the hydrogen, hydrogen should be present 10, so therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So therefore basically there are 10 hydrogen. So therefore this is the first isomer that we have drawn, and that also correctly. But we have also to mention to draw the bond line formula. So how can we draw the bond line formula? It is very simple to understand, because this carbon, this isomer consists of 5 carbon atoms that have been present in a straight chain. So we could write it in this manner. This is for the first carbon, second, third, fourth, and this is fifth. So this is the zigzag format that we have drawn for. I've clearly indicated as a dot over here, so as we could understand that the number of carbon atoms, and we could also write it in this manner. So in this manner also we could write, but this is for me, that so as to make you understand that these are indicating the carbon atoms. And and in this case basically, the as we have numbered over here, so the same sequence we will number over here also, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the carbon-carbon double bond is present at carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, that is carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore I would write over here, or I would draw in such a way that this will indicate carbon-carbon double bond. So this is the bond line formula of the first isomer of C5H10, but the work is not yet been done. We have to provide the IUPAC name also. So talking about the IUPAC name, we could observe this one or this one, the both would be the same. So in this basically it consists of 5 carbon atoms that are present in straight chain, calling that to be known as pentene. But the carbon-carbon double bond is present at carbon number 1, so therefore the name of this would be pent-1-ene. Simple. So this is the first isomer of the molecular formula C5H10, or the structural formula of C5H10 in terms of an isomer. So let us draw the next isomer that we could make. So the next isomer would be basically the known as position isomer. The reason behind that is in the previous one, that is in the first isomer, we have made a carbon-carbon double bond between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, as we could take a glimpse of this. Between carbon number 2 and carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. But the second would be possible, that the double bond would be between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, and the carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 will have only a single bond between them. So even that is also possible. So that is what we are going to make, the different possibility of the isomer C5H10. So talking about this one, that is, it will again consist of 5 carbon atoms that are being present in a straight chain. But yes, the isomer doesn't mean that all will have a straight chain, that is, all the 5 carbon will be in a straight chain. There will be a branching also. But let us go on step to step and let us see that what are the different kind of possibility that we could observe. So therefore, this is the first carbon, second, third, fourth, and fifth. So in initial, that is in the first isomer, the carbon number 1 and carbon, between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, that is, the double bond was being present. But now we could indicate between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, the double bond is being present. So now we are going to fulfill the hydrogen over here. So we could fulfill it over here as CH3. Here also it would be CH3. Here it would be CH. Here again it would be CH, and here it would be basically CH2, indicating that there are total 10 hydrogen atoms over here in the molecule. And now the main task is to give the bond length formula. Since the 5 carbon atoms are present in a straight chain, so for we can make a zigzag line in this format, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let us name this, number this also as 1, 2, 3, 4, and the carbon-carbon double bond is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, which is over here, carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So we could make a double bond over here also. So this indicates the carbon carbon double bond is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. And yes, the last task is to give the IUPAC nomenclature. Yes, the nomenclature of this one would be very much easy because it consists of 5 carbon atoms that are present in a straight chain or in the longest form. And since 5 carbon atoms are present in longest form, so that basically we could consider as a pentane when it comes to an alkane. But this is not an alkane, this is an alkene. So therefore, the name of this would be pentane. But here, the position of the double bond is also playing a very important role, and that's the reason we would also indicate the position of the carbon-carbon double bond, and here it is carbon number 2. So therefore, the reason, the name of this would be pentane, but it would be pentene, but pent-2-ene. So this is the IUPAC nomenclature of the second isomer that we have made. So let us move on to the third isomer. So suppose before moving to the third isomer, if I think that the double bond should be between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, whether that would be an isomer? No, that won't be an isomer. The reason behind that is, suppose if the double bond is between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4 in this case, and the single bond is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 and all. So if I mention the double bond over here, that won't be considered as the IUPAC nomenclature. The reason behind that is, at this end, if double bond is over here, then the numbering will start from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If this is the carbon-carbon double bond between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, if I number it from this end, then what will happen? This will generate the same IUPAC name as this one. So that's the reason I can't make a double bond over between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. So therefore, I have to choose another kind of isomer. So that is what I have wanted to mention you. And let us move on to the other isomer where we cannot find double bond between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, which is eventually nothing but pent to E. So now, move on. So the next kind of isomer that we could observe is where we could find 4 carbon atoms that have been present in a straight chain and a branching that we could observe over there. So therefore, here is the 4 carbon atoms that have been attached, and in this case, suppose a branching or a substituent has been attached over here in this case, like this one. And this is an alkane structure that we have drawn, but this is not an alkene. We have to represent an alkene also, and that should contains one double bond. So suppose if the double bond is present over here, that is carbon-carbon double bond is present over here. And now, just fulfill the hydrogen atoms, so therefore this would be CH3, here also CH3. Here it will be CH2, the reason behind of the valency, as we know, as we have discussed in earlier lecture also. No need of the hydrogen over here, and this would be CH2. So this is what we have drawn, the isomer of the third isomer of C5H10. But to draw the bond line formula, it is very essential for us to indicate the numbers also, because the bond line formula that we have drawn, we could draw it without the reference of the number, but if we have numbered this a long chain, it would be very much beneficial for us. How? Let me tell you. Suppose if I number this as 1, and the reason behind that is I have to select the longest chain. I have to select the longest chain in such a manner where the carbon-carbon double bond should be present. So therefore, this is the longest chain that I could get, and I am numbering it as 1, 2, 3, and 4. And in this case, basically, I could see that the carbon-carbon double bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore, now I could easily make a bond line formula of that, where this could be written as 4 carbon atoms that are in a straight chain. So therefore, making it to form a zigzag line of 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is indicating, this ends are, and this intersections are basically indicating the carbon atoms. And while talking about the carbon-carbon double bond, the carbon-carbon double bond is present between carbon number 1 and 2. So therefore, here also we are going to number it. And we are indicating the number between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, that is the double bond between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. But we could also see that a methyl group is present at carbon number 2. So therefore, I could make the structure to look in this way. This indicates basically the methyl group. So this is the bond line formula of the above structure. I could have drawn it with the blue ink, but just as to remind that this is nothing but a branching one, a branch substituent. So now let us give the IUPAC name to this one. So the IUPAC name of this one would be very much easy to give. That is, we have numbered it, so it would be very much easy. That is, and moreover, we could see that the 4 carbon atoms are been arranged in a straight chain and are been attached in a straight chain. And 4 carbon indicates butane when it comes to an alkane, but this is not butane, this is butene. And the specification of this is about the carbon-carbon double bond. That is, the carbon-carbon double bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore, the name of this would be but-1-ene. But is this the correct answer? No, because we have not mentioned the methyl groups over here. So that's the reason we are going to name the methyl group also, or the substituent also, in this manner. So therefore, the name of this would be basically 2-methyl-but-1-ene. So this is the third isomer that we have mentioned about. So let us think that, suppose if the double bond is over here, that is, if between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, suppose it is a single bond, and between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, if there is a double bond, can we make that as an isomer, or will it resemble to any other isomer that we have drawn over earlier? No, we could easily make a carbon number, a carbon-carbon double bond over here. So therefore, the fourth kind of isomer would be, the fourth isomer would be basically 4 carbon atoms that would be attached in a straight chain, and here it would be basically a carbon that is would be attached, and between carbon number 1, so let me give the numbering first, 1, 2, 3, 4 as a straight chain, and between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 there is double bond. So this is how we can make it. And now the thing that we have to do is, yes, we have to just fulfill the hydrogen atoms. So therefore, this would be CH3, this would be CH3, again this would be CH3, and no need of hydrogen to be fulfilled over here, and this would be CH. So now bond line formula would be very easy to make. So I would make all the 4 carbon atoms to form in a zigzag line, as I could mention over here. So this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, and 4. And between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, I could see a double bond. So I would write over here as carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 have double bond. And this methyl group can be indicated in this manner, as I have written over here. It's very clear. And now the thing is, we have to name it, but the naming will be in such a manner where I could see that the methyl group is attached on the second carbon atom, making this to be known as 2-methyl. And the parent chain is of butene, so, but the carbon-carbon double bond is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, making it to be known as 2-methyl-but-2-ene. So this is what we have mentioned, the fourth isomer that we have drawn over here. And let us go with the another one. So Let us move on with the another one. Suppose fifth, if I have drawn over here, and again suppose if I am making four carbon atoms, and in this case suppose if I have made a double bond over here and if I have attached a carbon over here, so will this be a new structure? No, this will be related to the third structure that we have drawn earlier also. So the thing that we have to do is we have to make a new structure, and it should not be resembled to any structure that we have drawn earlier in this isomer, regarding this isomer. So the thing is, we will draw in such a manner that the double bond would be over here and one carbon would be attached over here. So that is what we are going to do, and let us fulfill the hydrogen atoms. So this would be CH3, this would be CH3, here it would be CH2, and talking about this, here would be CH and here would be CH. So clearly indicating that there are basically 10 hydrogen atoms that are being now fulfilled, and now it comes to the numbering. So if I number this, so I have to number from which end, this end or this end? Yes, I have to number from this end because it is very close to the double bond. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, and now I could easily make a bond line formula. So that could be written in this way, where four carbon atoms have been arranged in this manner, in a straight manner, and between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 there is a double bond. And branching I could observe in at carbon number 3. So therefore this is the branching, suppose if I have mentioned over here. So this is the bond line formula, and ultimately the thing is that is remaining is giving the nomenclature, that is IUPAC nomenclature. So starting with the methyl groups or the substituent that are been attached, so at the third position basically the substituent is been attached as a methyl. So therefore 3-methyl will be the name of the substituent, and the straight chain consists of 4 carbon atoms, indicating the carbon double bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore 3-methyl, for 4 carbon atoms it is basically known as butane, in terms of alkane, but in terms of alkane it is known as butane. So it is but-1-ene. So this is the IUPAC nomenclature of this one that we have drawn. So is there any other possibility that we could make another isomer? Suppose if this attachment that is over the third carbon atom, that is CH3 would be been attached, and suppose if this would be have attached on CH, this fourth carbon atom, would that be an isomer? No, that would be a straight chain, and that straight chain is the first isomer that we have mentioned for C5H10. So now this is the ultimate thing that we have made the isomers of. And we have also drawn the structure of the bond line format and given the IUPAC. But in this case, basically there are position isomers also that we have observed, and the isomer 1 and 2 that we have mentioned, where we could see that the double bond is between carbon number 1 and 2 and between carbon number 2 and 3 respectively. So they were basically the position isomers, and in this case various isomers also we have obtained, and various class of isomers. And talking about the next thing, that in this case we have also found out the cis and trans isomer, means an isomer that could exhibit basically cis and trans isomer, even that is what we were able to find out that also. So let me talk about that. So I'm talking about this one. This is the one where we could see a possible structure where it can show a cis and trans isomer, where if I arrange in a 3D manner or in a spatial arrangement, this CH3 would be and this C2H5 would be on one side and this 2H will be on lower side. So cis trans isomer, basically EZ isomer that I am talking about, even that would be exhibited by this thing. So there are different kind of isomers that would be shown by C5H10. So that is what I want to discuss about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with the friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.